Myself PV Ekhande, working as an assistant professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering at Walchand Stop Technology Solapur. Today we'll go through the problems related to the projections of planes where the strike and dip of the plane is given, and we'll be completing the projections of the plane from the given data, and certain part of the figure will be also given to us. At the end of this session, students will be able to draw the problems of projections of planes related to strike and dip of the plane. Let us see this problem where the top view of the plane is given, in which PH, QH and RH, these are the three corners of the triangular plane PQR, and PF point is known to us. For this, the question is like this: draw front view of the triangle ABC, rather we'll consider here as a triangle PQR because the points given are PQR, having strike south 60 west and dip angle is 45 degrees and dip direction is northwesterly. And for this figure, which is given to us, is top view of the PQR and front view of the point PF is given, and we are going to complete the front view of the triangular plane PQR with the known strike, known dip angle and known dip direction. Now the first step is to draw the strike line of the plane in the top view. You know that the strike line is always to be obtained or always obtained in the top view only, where this strike line has got the angle 60 in between west, south and west direction, because strike given is south 60 degrees west. So this direction is south direction, this direction is west direction, and the angle given is 60 degrees angle. So the angle 60 degrees with respect to P is to be considered. Now this angle 60 degrees will consider with respect to PH. Now this PH point with respect to this, the angle 60 degrees with vertical line is to be considered, because the angle is from south to west. So this south to west direction angle will represent strike line of the plane. So this is strike line of the plane, which is nothing but the horizontal line from the plane, or true length of the line, which is called as a horizontal line, which will be having the parallelity with respect to ground or with respect to HRP, and this line is called as a strike line. Now to this strike line, we have to consider plane perpendicular for obtaining its auxiliary view, where we can get the edge view of the plane. You know that the edge view of the plane is obtained when we are considering the true length line from the plane to which we are taking the auxiliary plane. Here the auxiliary plane is H1, and this auxiliary plane is perpendicular to this strike line, and strike line is nothing but true length line of the plane, which is a horizontal line. To this, when we take the plane perpendicular, we will get edge view of the plane on this side. Now to obtain this edge view of the plane, first we have to locate the point PF, which is to be transferred from XY line or FH line. Now this point is at 21 millimeter distance above HRP. This point will mark on the line drawn with respect to PH, and this is a position of point P in the auxiliary plane number 1. So we'll call that point as a P1. Now with respect to this P1 point, now we have to complete the dip of the plane. Now for completing the dip of the plane, we have to first consider the dip direction. Now the dip direction given is northwesterly, means from north direction towards west direction, the plane is having inclination. So this dip direction we have to represent in the top view as a line perpendicular to strike line, which can be represented at this position with respect to P point, or we can represent the deep direction anywhere with respect to strike line as a line perpendicular. So this line is representing deep direction. So this deep direction, in this direction the plane should have a downward inclination. What is mean by downward inclination? If we consider the man standing on this plane, when the position of man is considered on this plane, which is the horizontal plane and one plane intersection, if the man is standing on the horizontal plane, his position on this side can be also obtained in this way, because we are transferring the points on this side towards the auxiliary plane, or from auxiliary plane we can transfer the point on the front view side. Now when you consider the man standing on the horizontal plane, this is the head of the man, foot are on the bottom side which are touching to the horizontal plane. The same thing when we transfer from this side towards this side, the foot are touching to HRP, the man is having the head on the top side. So this way we have to consider the position in the downward direction for the line, for the AG of the plane, which is nothing but the line observed over here as a line having the inclination towards the HRP or towards the ground. Now this angle is 45 degrees. Now this 45 degrees is to be considered with respect to horizontal line. We have to always consider the angle with respect to horizontal. In this case it is 45. So with respect to this, when we consider 45 degrees, it will have the 45 on the opposite side also, that is a vertical line. But when the line AG angle is, suppose deep angle is 60 degrees, in that case this 60 degrees angle should be considered with respect to this horizontal line, means the line will have the 60 degrees angle with respect to this line. From this we'll take the angle 60 if the angle is 60. If the 30, in that case we have to consider 30 degrees angle. In this case it is 45 degrees, so we'll draw the line at 45 degrees angle with respect to this. So this line is the AG of the plane. Now this line is representing AG of the plane. Now this AG of the plane is making angle 45 degrees with respect to ground. So this angle is 45, or at this location also when you consider, that angle is 45 degrees. So this 45 degrees angle is a deep angle. Deep direction is a northwesterly, and that's why we have taken downward inclination on this side. If the deep direction is suppose southeasterly, in that case the south towards east, that will have the perpendicular line, and this direction is the direction in which we have to consider the downward inclination, means the plane AG will be drawn in this way. In that case it will have the downward inclination on this side with respect to the man. In this case with respect to that man, we have considered inclination in this side. Inclination is considered in this direction because it is north westerly. If it is southeasterly, in that case it will have the direction in this way, and in this direction the angle is to be completed for the AG of the plane. Now once we complete the AG of the plane over here, with respect to this AG of the plane, on this AG of the plane, we'll get the remaining two points. And for obtaining remaining two points, we have to draw the projector from these points. This point is a point RH from which we have taken the projector. The intersection over here will have the point R1. Similarly, when we consider the projector from Q, the projectors are always 90 degrees to reference line. So these are the three projectors which are completed at 90 degrees. Now on this projector the intersection is over here. So this intersection is Q1 point. Now the point R1 to Q1, that is AG of the plane. So this much length, that is from R1 to Q1, is AG of the plane. So this AG is auxiliary view. Now where to locate RF and QF point in the front view? by transferring these distances. Now first we have to draw the projector of RF. On the projector of RH, we'll get the position of RF. On the projector of this, we have to now transfer the distance of R1. Now R1 has got distance 10 millimeter, 11 millimeter. So this 11 millimeter distance, when we transfer on this side, we'll get the position of RF. Now this transfer of the distance we have to consider with respect to, with the help of compass. With the help of compass, we have to mark the distance on this side. Similarly, for the another point Q, we'll have the projector from this side. Now on this projector, we'll transfer the distance of Q1 with compass, or we can take the scale. Now the distance is 50 millimeter. So this 50 millimeter distance will transfer on this side. Now this is the position of QF point. Now once we connect these three points, that gives us front view of the plane PRF or PQR. So this is completion of front view of the plane. Top view is already given to us. So with the known data like this, we can complete the projection of plane. And in the other way also, we can go for the projections. Means the front view will be given to us, a point in the top view will be known to us. We have to complete the top view with the given strike and dip of the plane. Okay, have you understood how to complete the projections when the strike and dip is given and one of the view and one point is given in the adjacent view? For this, the reference which has been taken is from the engineering graphics book by Professor Deshpande, which is a book of the Mahalakshmi publications. Thank you.